أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Dear brothers and sisters, as you know, this is our series of Ramadan Reflections and Dua. We do this every year. And inshallah, this is our second year for this series of talk and reflections. So tonight we have invited our respected former National Amir of Islamic Circle of North America, Dr. Muhammad Yunus. Inshallah, Dr. Muhammad Yunus will talk to us regarding the revival of the month of revival, Ramadan, the month of revival. So inshallah, I'm going to ask brother Dr. Muhammad Yunus to please share his reflections of Ramadan. And then after 8 minutes, dua for all of us. Jazakumullah.
Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون صدق الله العظيم We are in our blessed month of Ramadan and we are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with his rahmah and when with his maghfirah. And now we are in the last ashra of Ramadan, which is itqum min an-nar, the freedom from hellfire. And we make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us, accept our good deeds, inshallah ta'ala. The purpose of this short presentation is to establish the centrality of taqwa for the fasting month and its close relationship and our efforts and struggle to revive the quality of taqwa in us through the fasting. So this revival, which is an important function in Ramadan, is primarily focused upon taqwa, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us very clearly in Surah Al-Baqarah that He has made fasting obligatory with one purpose, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you are become people of taqwa. So what is the revival in itself? The revival is to return the interest, deep interest in its purpose, and to return to the strength and importance of its purpose, which is taqwa. And then to have such meetings as we are having this evening to stir up a religious fervor and feelings and commitment to achieve the purpose of fasting. So this Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, which now we are in the last part of it, this is a time of revitalization, iman, taqwa, and commitment for spiritual cleansing and to achieve the ultimate status, which is the status of ihsan. The steps for this revival, which we must have taken, and if not to take now, is first of all to have a sense of deep reflection upon our status of iman, to assess our level of faith. Where do we stand? And this assessment is an ongoing process. It's not just in Ramadan, but throughout our life, we should be assessing where do we stand. And also we must make constant efforts. Of course, in Ramadan, our efforts are increased, and we try to make maximum efforts in this month, but it has to go on throughout the year. And then as a result of achieving this taqwa and the status of ihsan, we must show in our action, and that action should include not only our ibadat, but the humanitarianism, not only in the month of Ramadan, but throughout the year, to serve the humanity at large. We serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our sincere ibadah, and then the humanity at large also. Now, these are the four levels of iman, which we find in the hadith of Jibreel, which I will share with you briefly. But ulama tell us that these are the various steps. The first stage is of Islam, that is to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our a'mal, in our ibadah. The second is the sincere iman, which is a condition of the heart, which we have to work on it constantly, because iman increases and decreases based upon our efforts and our amal. Then the next stage is a taqwa of Allah, which is the inner consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's presence. And then ultimate stage is the ihsan, which is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and excellence in our amal. And Hadith of Jibreel is a long hadith, and we don't have time to go into that. But in that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he answered some questions posed by Jibreel alayhi salam, who came in the form of a man, and he asked about what is Islam? Akhbirni anil Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then explained that it means that you should declare shahada, establish salat, pay zakat, fast month of Ramadan and Hajj when you have the ability. And then he asked, "Fakhbirni anil iman." Tell me about iman. And of course, he explained the various components of the iman: billah, malaikatihi, kutubihi, rusuli, wal yawmil akhir, wa tu'minu bil qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi. And then he asked about "Fakhbirni anil ihsan." And he said, "An ta'budu Allah ka'annaka tarahu, fa in lam takun tarahu fa innahu yarak." That you should worship Allah as if you are able to see him. But if not, at least know that he is watching you. So these stages and levels of iman, we should know. But the one who achieves the taqwa and then ultimately the ihsan, that person is able to taste the sweetness of the iman. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Zaqa ta'amal iman man radiya billahi rabbam bil islami deenam wa bi muhammadin rasoola sallallahu alaihi wasallam." The one who is pleased with his Lord Allah as his Rabb, and Islam as his way of life, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as Rasul of Allah, then that person has tasted the sweetness of the iman. And then taqwa has been well explained in the Quran. The ayah recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us, "Ittaqullaha haqqa tuqatih." You should develop the taqwa, the status of full submission to him, the way it should be done. And then ihsan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded, "Wahsinu inna Allah yuhibbul muhsinin." Allah loves those who do the ihsan. And hal jazaa'ul ihsan illa al ihsan. The reward for ihsan is going to be the ihsan by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. And about the taqwa, we know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one hadith said, that the people will enter the Jannah is because of taqwa. Aksar ma yudkhilun nas al Jannah. He was asked, what is the a'mal which lead the person to Jannah? He said, faqala taqwa Allah wa husnul khuluq. That taqwa of Allah and the best conduct and character. This is what takes you to Jannah. And about the taqwa, Imam Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he defined the best. What is taqwa? He said, "At-taqwa huwa al-khawf min al-jaleel wal-amal bit-tanzeel wal-rida bil-qaleel wal-istida'ad li-yawm al-rahil." The taqwa is fear of Almighty Allah, compliance with the Quran, and contentment with the little one, what one has in his sustenance, and preparation for the journey to the eternity. That is the taqwa. And the taqwa's station is in the heart. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one hadith said, "At-taqwa hahuna." وَيُشِيرُ إِلَىٰ صَدْرِهِ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتٍ. That taqwa is in your heart. And then there, some scholars explained that there are 5 degrees of taqwa. The first one is Islam, that is submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is tawbah, to be cautious about sins and do tawbah all the time. And third level is a wara. Wara is to be cautious about doubtful things. And the fourth one is zuhud, which is to stay with very little out of the permissible things. And we should not run after those to amass that, to collect that, and to be involved in dunya too much. And the final thing is mushahida, which is the love of Allah, to develop that in our heart. Nothing enters but the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then how to gain taqwa? There are 4 different ways. One is to make a sincere intention, ikhlas lillah. And then make dua to Allah. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-'ifaf wa al-ghina. And then to follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he said, Wallahi inni la'akhshakum lillah wa taqakum lahu. I am the most, the person who fears Allah and his taqwa for Allah. So if we follow his Sunnah, we achieve the taqwa. And Imam Malik rahmatullah alayhi said that as-sunnatu safinatu nuh, man rakibaha najah, wa man takhallafa anha ghoraqa. The one who followed the sunnah, he is already in the ark of Nuh alayhi salam. He's saved. The one who leaves there doesn't ride the safina of Nuh alayhi salam, then he is going to drown. So there is, of course, we know a close connection with taqwa and the month of Ramadan, and we should do everything possible to achieve the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By this time that we are end of Ramadan, we hope and pray to Allah that we have made efforts to achieve taqwa, to revive our sense of taqwa, and to revive our efforts in order to achieve ihsan and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with this, I conclude my presentation and summarize in this way that there's a need for all of us, particularly those who are workers of Islamic movement, to revitalize our commitment to taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make struggle to achieve the status of ihsan. If tawheed is the soul of Islam, taqwa is the oxygen that nourishes the soul. And taqwa provides the impetus that revitalizes our belief in sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has an important role to play in the progress of humanity in our everyday life. So with this, I just make dua, Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. And now inshallah, before we conclude, we all make du'as to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the balance of the time. And we start with the praise of Allah and the salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma ni as'aluka bi anna laka alhamda la ilaha illa anta wahdaka la sharika lak. المنان بديع السماوات والأرض يا ذو الجلال والإكرام يا حي يا قيوم اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا واجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد ربنا إننا آمنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آمنا بما أنزلت واتبعنا الرسول فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيت وما للظالمين من أنصار ربنا فاغفرنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك واغننا بفضلك عمن سواك اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب النار ونعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ونعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن ونعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا وعافنا وارزقنا اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وغلبة العدو وشماتة الأعداء اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه وأهل بيته أجمعين آمين يا رب العالمين
Ameen. Jazakallah khair, Dr. Yunus, for your beautiful reminder and reflections. Inshallah, we will see each other tomorrow night again. So till tomorrow night, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam. Wa alaikum assalam. Wa alaikum assalam. Wa alaikum assalam.